Here is the video featuring the best passing footballers of all time. Naturally, it's a virtual team. Making it, I try to think as a coach, selecting not only the strongest, although it was the main point of course, but also those who complement each other in the best possible way, who can disguise the weaknesses of the others and combine different type of skills. In the end, it has led to some surprises. You will find out them while watching this video.
It's evident that the goalkeeper of this team should be from the modern generation. The prominent number ones from the 1970s and 1980s used to pass by their arms, and in the 1990s the picture was basically the same. Neuer is not the first in his role who often acts as a genuine outfield player, but it was he who led goalkeepers' passing skills on another level and proved himself in the biggest scenes. I promised some surprises, and here's one of them. The irony is that nowadays almost nobody recognized Tassotti as a great passer, after infamous incident in 1994 when he deliberately broke Luis Enrique's nose. The Italian has to live with the reputation of villain. Meanwhile, playing for the great AC Milan at the intersection of the 1980s and 1990s, it was he who selected the direction of attack most of the time. Tassotti passes almost always were not only precise and technically immaculate, but also sharp, often sharp enough in order to create goals. For instance, he gave an assist in each of the last three AC Milan games in the memorable Champions Cup 1988-1989 campaign. Who else from right backs could brag about it? The answer is obvious. Sometimes a good dribbling ability helps a player to be a better passer, and the Brazilian is a nice example of it. Adversaries at times simply give him free space, expecting that Marcelo will make his trademark slashing run, and he calmly finds an open man instead. If somebody control his another incentive. Marcelo could assist from almost every unnatural position, even lying on the pitch or being airborne. Such assortment of skills making him the best passing left back. Mediocre defender, slow and not particularly reliable, the Dutchman was much more effective in the attack. Koeman remembered for his outstanding goal scoring record and lethal shots, but he was also a superb playmaker. His vision of the pitch has been exceptional and his long passes even better, on the verge of perfection. These skills not the least made Barcelona's attacking play so smooth and spectacular during the first half of 1990s. The great German complements Koeman in the best possible way, offering a completely new dimension. While the Dutchman was the master of powerful shots and long passes, Beckenbauer was unsurpassed in the intelligent and witty link-up plays, regularly scoring after them despite his initial role of libero. Setting a standard of excellence for this position for decades, France also dictated a standard of manner. If we take the prominent German's last defenders, only Klaus Augenthaler played differently to him. There were plenty of great passing footballers on the right wing of attack. Chris Waddle, David Beckham and Luis Figo. Some of the older ones could recall the inimitable Garrincha. But this kind of competition only underlines Messi's unparalleled brilliance. Nobody in the history of this game didn't change the direction of play so regularly and effectively, and didn't provide so many assists. And at the age of 32, he will turn 33 in June. The Argentine still has a lot to offer. Being statistically inferior to his younger compatriot, Maradona still has an edge in terms of skills and sheer talent. It's hard to imagine Messi making passes in acrobatic jumps in the form of overhead kicks or being in a pretty unnatural position, while Diego did it regularly and masterfully without losing his unique vision of the pitch, creativity, composure and touch. There was no better entertainer than Maradona in the history of the game, and definitely there was no better passer. The great Frenchman was a rare type of star who instilled, or even dictated his own style of football in every team he played. So was Zinedine Zidane, but his main assets were rather amazing creativity and wittiness. As for the passes itself, Platini was more effective and stable, especially with take long and middle range. Another choice which seems controversial. There is a big temptation to place here somebody like Javi or Andrea Pirlo, but in this case the team would be overloaded by players who simply can't defend. There won't be such problem with the German, probably the most versatile player in the game's history in terms of skills. Just think of it. In 1990, Mateus was the best tackler of his star-stacked national team, the most resilient, explosive and agile player, and one of the fastest as well, and also the prime passer of it. What else? Well, he was the main scorer of the World Cup winning squad too. Amid this kind of flexibility, Lothar's passing ability is not so pronounced as it was in the cases of Javi and Pirlo, less dimensional footballers, but it doesn't mean that he is inferior to them in this regard. On the other hand, Mateus could run and defend for Messi, Maradona and Platini, while the Spaniard and the Italian could not. Therefore, his presence in this team makes it more real, or rather the real deal. There was no another player who has been so far ahead of his time, and it's a major part of Pelé's unmatched greatness. As a passer, he has every tool of the highest quality: vision, technique, body control and intelligence. Moreover, Pelé used them in the best possible way. In the 1970 World Cup, almost every time he touched the ball, it was a piece of art. Van Basten's reputation of a great goal scorer is so huge that it unwittingly overshadows his passing ability. In fact, while remaining true center forward with the appropriate array of skills, the Dutchman felt himself pretty comfortably in the middle of the pitch and was extremely good in the link-up plays. His famous assist to Frank Rijkaard in the Champions Cup 1990 final is a prime but far from the only example of it. As much as AC Milan missed him as a hitman, the loss of Van Basten as the best passing striker in the world was even bigger.
Indeed, this team is a matter of personal choice. There are plenty of classy players who could be included here. So I'm waiting for your notes and comments. What else? Probably that's it. Take care.